Here we have a question related to projectile motion, and it says that a boy throws a stone with a velocity of 30 meters per second in a direction 30 degrees above the horizon. Find its altitude, the time when it finally hits the ground, and horizontal range. Here I have a schematic diagram of the problem. Whenever you want to solve a numerical question, always make a schematic diagram because it helps you to understand the question very well. Once you understand the question very well, you can solve it very well. So suppose this is a stone and he throws it with the velocity 30 meters per second, making an angle 30 degrees with the horizontal line. So we need to find the altitude, the maximum height attained by the stone. And then we need to find the time of the total flight, the time it takes for the stone to achieve the maximum height, plus the time it takes for the stone from the maximum height to hit the ground. And then we will find the horizontal range, R, which is the horizontal displacement of the projectile from the initial to the final point. Let's go to the solution. So I have split the screen into two sections. In one section, I will do calculations related to vertical motion, and in the horizontal box, I will do calculations related to the horizontal motion of the stone, because we know we can split a projectile motion into two sections. So let's calculate the altitude first. I have written this equation because we have already derived this equation. You are familiar with it. So let me rewrite this equation with the values given in the question. So v squared, we know that velocity is 30 meters per second. So I will write it here, 30 meter per second, and is squared multiplied by sine of 30 degrees, because the angle it is making with the horizon is 30 degrees, and it's also squared divided by 2 multiplied by 9.8 meter per second squared. This is acceleration due to gravity. If I use my calculator, I get a final value of the height is 11.48 meters. I have fixed the accuracy of my calculator to 2 decimal places. So this is the maximum height achieved by the stone. Let's find the horizontal range of the stone. Here is the formula we derived earlier. R is equal to 2v squared sine theta cosine theta over g. So let's put the values and see what is the range of the stone. 2 times 30 meter per second whole squared sine of 30 degrees cosine of 30 degrees divided by 9.8 meter per second squared. So I can use my calculator to get the final value, which is 79.53 meters. Now it's time to calculate the time of flight, the total time it will take for the stone to hit the ground. I want to clear another point before I can solve this part of the question. Suppose this is a projectile and then it starts its journey with some initial velocity v, and finally it hits the ground here. So we calculated the time considering only the vertical motion of the projectile, the time it takes for the projectile to achieve the maximum height which we called it T1. And then we also calculated the time for the projectile to start from the maximum height and hit the ground again. That was T2. And we calculated the total time of flight as T1 plus T2. I want to clear one more thing, that this time should be equal to the time it takes for the projectile to start its journey from this point to the very end of the journey. So if it starts its journey from point A and ends its journey at point B, suppose this time is T. So this time T is equal to T1 plus T2. So just remember it when you are solving the questions. Now let's go to the question. Here I have the formula to calculate the total time of flight. So I will just plug in the values. T is equal to 2 multiplied by 30, the velocity. In fact, it's 30 meter per second. Multiplied by sine of 30 degrees. Divided by 9.8 meter per second squared. Once again, I can use my calculator to do all of these calculations, and it gives me the final result of 3.06 seconds. So this is the total time of flight. Now if I ask you to find all of these three quantities, altitude, the time when it finally hits the ground, or horizontal range, for the angle 45 degrees, or if I say that find all of these quantities if the angle of projection is 60 degrees, or any other value, it should be easy to solve, right? I'm sure you can solve it yourself.